Thank you for watching my channel. Please subscribe and like. Now back to the news. Marriage looks good on Jack Antonoff and Margaret Qualley. In exclusive pics obtained by Page Six, the newlyweds were absolutely beaming as they stepped out for the first time since becoming husband and wife. The couple, who said I do in a Starry, New Jersey ceremony last weekend, were spotted out and about in New York City Saturday. The music producer, 39, and the Fosse Verdon star, 28, were photographed holding hands as they took a romantic stroll through Manhattan's SoHo neighborhood. Qualley exuded old Hollywood glamour in a white silk dress featuring a high neckline and ruching at the waist. She paired the midi dress with black Chanel flats and a cream-colored trench coat, styling her curly locks in a glamorous half-up, half-down do. The Bleachers musician opted for an oversized bluish-gray suit, which he paired with navy blue sneakers. At one point, Antonoff took his suit jacket off, revealing a casual white tee. He also accessorized with a backwards baseball cap and a pair of glasses. Antonoff and Qualley's Nick outing came 1 week after their star-studded nuptials practically shut down Long Beach Island as Taylor Swift, Lana Del Rey, Channing Tatum, Zoe Kravitz, Cara Delevingne and more celebrities descended upon the popular New Jersey vacation destination. The cruel summer singer, 33, hilariously and lovingly roasted the couple during her lengthy toast, in which she dragged her frequent collaborator, Antonoff, for never thanking her in his speeches. Antonoff has won 8 Grammys, including Producer of the Year in 2022 and 2023, while Swift has taken home 12 throughout her career. After the reception, Qualley changed out of her white halter dress and billowing veil into a second white mully garter gown with puffy sleeves, as they kept the party going across the road at Bird and Betty's. Del Rey, 38, serenaded the newlyweds for their first dance to the tune of her song, Margaret, and guests celebrated until the early hours of the morning.